Year, plenty of people start reassessing their life goals and their jobs. For some, that means taking a giant leap of faith and starting their own business.
What if you have an idea but need some help to execute it? Eddie has more.
Got you covered, guys. One Australian company is helping people get their foot in the door and get their product to market. And those who've been through the process say it's time to just stop dreaming and do it.
Victoria Houlis used to work full-time in marketing until she called it quits to open a nail salon.
I just didn't really have the attention span for it and realised I was way more engaged when I was painting nails and talking to people.
With the help of Aussie company Atelier, Victoria also started selling products including nail stickers. Founder of skin software Neve Mooney has a similar story.
I was looking for something more impactful and meaningful. I'd spent 5 years working in corporate law and I just kept thinking to myself, is this it?
That's when she got the idea to create a medical grade skincare company. She made it happen with some expert advice.
We develop and manufacture beauty, health and wellness products. So if there's someone that's sitting at home who has the next great idea for a cult lipstick or a cult hair product, but they don't really know where to start, Atelier is the place for them to come and we will help them design, develop and manufacture that product.
Atelier assists Aussie entrepreneurs get their products to market from a startup cost of $1,500.
That's iterations of the chemistry, that's iterations of the packaging, to arrive at that perfect product.
Atelier made the transition to product quite seamless for me. I was pretty nervous because every time I'd research creating decals on my own, I kind of hit lots of dead ends about things that weren't the right quality, weren't produced the right way, or wouldn't work well with the products that I intend to use them with.
CEO Nick Benson says if you're sitting on a business idea, you've already got what it takes to get started.
We definitely see a big push from ex-corporate who have developed a certain set of skills, whether it's a marketing skill, a design skill, a managerial skill, and then want to use that skill in order to create their own thing.
The advice from those who've done it is don't wait.
Be brave and take the leap. You can always go back to your previous role, but you won't necessarily always have the opportunity to build your own business.
But quitting a job to start up a business isn't for everyone. Experts recommend beginning while you're still employed to ensure you've got a financial buffer. Getting professional help is also an important step, and confidence is key. No idea is ever too big.
It's those fringe ideas that are the ones that can be really interesting and create that next cult product.
Obviously a lot of risk involved as well, so you've got to have the mettle for this because you know a lot about this space. I saw a great suggestion the other day. Look at the comments on a product, identify what people are complaining about, and if you can feel that need, well, there you go. Yeah. You have a business idea.
Okay, if you've got a business idea, flyingsolo.com.au, great platform. Koshy's Business Builders.
Oh, okay.
And Startup Daily. All designed for budding entrepreneurs.
There you go. Thanks, Eddie. We have...